Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Sonnet with Sonnet's Garden Blooms, and I want to thank you all for stopping by. Now in today's video, we are going to be taking that silver case that I did pick on my last thrift haul, and we are going to convert it over into a really cool nightstand. I did receive quite a few comments saying I should go buy some hairpin legs and put those on the case and make it into a nightstand. And I did not have time to go pick those up, but I did pick a table out of the garbage recently. The top was pretty much junk, so I took the legs off of it, and that's what we're gonna use today to convert that case into a table. If you haven't been to my channel before, what you're gonna find is a lot of DIY, thrift hauls, thrift flips, and really I like to bring you along during my business journey. So if you do like that type of channel, go ahead, hit that subscribe button, and turn on your bell notification so every Monday and Friday you'll be notified when I upload a video. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I can't wait to hear what you guys all think. So here is that case that I picked in my last thrift haul. And like I said, it really caught my eye. Right away, I thought, I am going to turn this like into a vintage looking suitcase. And really what I heard from a lot of the viewers was turn it into a nightstand, buy some hairpin legs. And like I said, I did not have time to do that. But I am repurposing some legs that I picked out of the garbage. This is such a cool case though, and it does have like cedar inside, so I really don't know what was stored in here originally, but it will be a perfect nightstand. So here are the legs that I did pick out of the garbage, and I don't know if any of you have been following along for a while, but there was a little pink nightstand that I picked a while ago, and the top was really ratty. I know everyone was like, don't get rid of it, because initially I was going to toss the whole thing, and then I decided to keep the legs. So I took the legs off of the top, and they've been in my garage for a while, and I'm like, that is what I'm going to use, and it made it a perfect height, and they're very sturdy too, so I'm really excited about this. So we're gonna use Krylon spray paint, and this is gloss red. I typically do not use gloss, but it's what I had on hand. And my vision with this is, if you all remember, I did do a toolbox a while ago, and it was red, and then I did Farm Fresh over that, and I loved that look, and that's what we're gonna do today. So the key was taped to the top of this case, and when I pulled the tape off, it left like this residue. So something you guys can all use is called goof off, and I just put it on there and it takes off all that sticky residue with just a few wipes, and it works awesome. So here it is. I put it on. I just squirted a bunch of it on to absorb into that sticky residue. And I just take a little piece of paper towel and I just go around, and it almost like makes it into little chunks, and it comes right off. So now I'm just gonna be spray painting the whole case the red. And I did apply basically two coats to the entire piece just to give it a real good coverage. So here it is completely sprayed, and it is drying, just to give you a look what it looks like with just the actual spray paint. Then I start tackling the legs, and they were pink, so the red just covered them right up and not a problem. And with these, I only had to apply one coat of the red, I think because of the pink underneath. So next I'm going to take Farm Fresh. It is a DIY clay-based paint, and I am applying two coats of this paint to the legs and to the entire piece. If many have asked about this brush that I've been using, one of my viewers did send this to me, and it's one of my favorite brushes. It goes on really well. So here I am, I'm just going ahead and applying the two coats to the legs, and then going ahead and applying it to the base.
So here is the case, and the red paint is completely dry, and I am trying to beat a storm today. So I'm outside enjoying the warm weather, but a storm is coming. So I wanted to get the two coats on as quick as possible, and I love the chalk paint or the clay style paint from DIY. It is such a great paint to use. But one thing that you must know is that it does reactivate. So anytime you're using it, you have to apply some type of top coat to seal it, whether that be a big top or a poly or any type of wax. So just a tip for you. And I know I talk about that often, but I do have a lot of new viewers that may or may not know that. So now that the two coats of paint are completely dry on both the legs and the base, I am going to use tight bond, and we are going to put tight bond on the top of the leg. And I am going to initially take my brad nailer, and I am going to put in two brad nails to hold the leg in place. And then I'm going to go back and I am going to apply two screws to each leg to really make that leg nice and sturdy. But here I'm showing you how I'm putting in that brad nail. And it's the easiest way to do that by having those brad nails in there. The rest of the legs went on extremely easy after I did the first one, and here I am just showing you a different angle of how I'm doing that, and I just go lean in, hold it real tight, and then put in the two brad nails. It would definitely have been helpful to have another set of hands, but it was pretty easy. So here is the project to this point. I have all four legs on. It is completely painted, and it is just, I touched up a few areas and it's drying. Now a storm is on the horizon, so I need to pack my stuff up and get in the house, and we're gonna finish it inside. So now that we're inside, I took a wet rag and we are going to wet distress it. And I'm just showing you how I'm taking the rag and just wet distressing it over all the edges and the raised areas. I just want enough of that red to come through. I really liked that look, like I said, from that toolbox that I did, and that is what I'm going for. So I'm going ahead and just, like I said, applying enough pressure to those areas, and when my rig does get full of the paint, I just go rinse it out and then come right back and just continue on. In some areas where there's a little bit more paint, I just have to have a little bit more elbow grease, but it's pretty easy and it cuts down on the dust tremendously. So now I picked the piece up and I set it up on a chair. I want to make sure that the legs have enough distressing and the back. I really like to finish all my pieces, so I know that in most cases people probably will not see the back of the table, but maybe there would be a time. So I'm finishing that off, and I also just want to make sure that on the legs that the inside has the distressing as well. So here is the project to this point. I've completely distressed it. I have the red peeking out. I went back and I actually wanted a little bit more red coming through here and there. So I did that to those little corners, even on the legs. And I'm really loving how this is looking. But now we are going to finish the project. And I am using a big top to completely seal the whole piece. And after you use the big top, what I do recommend, and do not do what I did the first time that I applied a transfer, because we are going to go back and apply some transfers to this. What you want to make sure is that the big top or the poly, whatever you're using to seal it, is completely dry. And if it's not, your transfer will not adhere to it. It will actually peel the paint right off. So that's a tip. The other tip is if you're using a wax, you cannot use the actual transfer. The transfer will not stick to the wax either. So just a couple tips for you. And here I'm just, like I said, applying the top coat, big top, and I'm going to let this dry and then come back and I'll show you what transfers I'm using and where my vision is going with this. So I'm using the transfer Ladies in Waiting and a piece from the new transfer Desperado. So I'm starting off with the Ladies in Waiting, and I'm gonna continue to cut this piece apart a little bit more to make it fit on the top how I want it. So now that I have it all cut down, I'm just gonna peel the backing off, and I am going to place it so exactly, I want the stem to be touching the edge, and I want the other leaf to kind of like fold over the edge. So just like that. Then I take, with every transfer from IOD, you do get a transfer stick, and I just rub all the way over the whole entire piece. Now, all the supplies that I'm using in the video today, if you are interested in any of those, you can order them on my website, which is sonnetsgardenblooms.com. So I'm just gonna start off on one corner as I'm rubbing the transfer stick, and I'm gonna just pick up one of the edges and then start peeling it back and continuing to rub. And that's how easy the transfers are to use. So it goes on extremely easy, and it just transforms your pieces. So now that I have the flower on, this is where I'm going to add that seine from the Desperado set. And the nice thing about the transfers too is that there are grid lines on there, so you can really make sure that your whole entire piece is straight. And I, again, just rub it very easily, and then I just start with one edge and I work my way over, and it comes right off.
So what did you all think? I actually loved it. I can't wait to get it in my booth. I'm actually debating whether or not I should line the inside. I know it does have that cedar in there, but I'm thinking of just putting a liner on the bottom because I did use screws to screw down the legs and just to do like a fit more finished look. So I think I'm going to just take a piece of some type of like wrapping paper or some kind of cardstock and put it in there and line it. But one last request from all of you. I know that on my last video, I did mention that I'm going to be providing more content over on Facebook. I do have a goal set that by the end of the year, I do hit 10,000 followers on Facebook. So I hope you all can help me with that. If you do love my content over here on YouTube, I am going to be starting to add way more content on Facebook. I did hear some of you don't like Facebook, and I totally understand. But for those of you that are out there, I do have my business page, so go ahead, give that a follow. I also have my group page out there as well. So you can go ahead and like both of those. But again, on June 20th, I am going to be kicking off a bunch of new content over on my Facebook page. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and on Friday, I am going to be doing a thrift flip. It is going to be all the items that I picked in Florida. So we will see you guys Friday, and you have a wonderful week. Bye.